Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create the look of a vintage automobile chrome logo. I provided this image of a close-up of an automobile's panel that you can use to place your chrome logo onto. Its link is located in the video's description or project files. Open your horizontal type tool and pick a font for your automobile logo type. I'm using Remarcle Regular, which has a vintage industrial feel. If you'd like to use it, I provided its link as well. I'll make its size 104 points, but feel free to use a size that works for the font you use and the amount of characters in your text. I'll make the anti-aliasing sharp and center alignment. Click the color box to open the color picker. We'll make the color a medium gray. The hue and saturation are both 0, and for the brightness, type in 70. Then click OK. Click on your document and type out your text. To adjust the space between your characters, highlight the line of text and press and hold Alt or Option as you press the right or left arrow key on your keyboard. To reposition it, open your Move tool and move it. Click the FX icon and click Bevel Emboss. The style is inner bevel, the technique is smooth, and the depth is 600%. The direction is up, the size is 40 pixels, and soften it 5 pixels. Global light is checked. The angle is 120 degrees. And the altitude is 30 degrees. The highlight color is white, its mode is screen, and the opacity is 75%. The shadow is black, its mode is multiply, and its opacity is 75% as well. Then click OK or press Enter or Return. We'll convert our text into a smart object so we can modify the filters that we'll be adding at any time, as well as replace our text without having to redo many of the effects. Click the icon at the upper right of the Layers panel and click Convert to Smart Object. Make a copy of it by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Click the eyeball icon next to the layer to hide the copy, and click the thumbnail of the original layer to make it active. Click the FX icon, and click Inner Glow. The color is white, the blend mode is screen, and the opacity is 75%. The source is edge, the choke is 10%, and the size is 7 pixels. Then click OK or press Enter or Return. Reduce its opacity to 60%. Make the top layer visible and active. Click the FX icon and click Bevel Emboss. The style is outer bevel, the technique smooth, and the depth is 100%. The direction is up, the size is 7 pixels, and soften is 0. The angle is 120 degrees, and the altitude is 30 degrees. Open the Gloss Contour Flyout list and click this preset, which is called Ring Double. Click Contour and open the flyout list. Click this preset, which is called Half Round. Click Drop Shadow. The color is black, the blend mode is multiply, and the opacity is 50%. The angle is 120 degrees, the distance is 15 pixels, and the size is 30 pixels. Then click OK. To save space in the Layers panel, let's collapse the effects in both layers by clicking the small arrows next to the FX icons. With the top layer still active, click the adjustment layer icon and click Curves. To restrict the adjustment layer to affect just the one layer under it, we need to clip it to that layer. To do this, either click the Clipping Mask icon or press Ctrl-Alt-G on Windows or Command-Option-G on a Mac. The key to making our image look like Chrome is to apply modified double bell curves. Drag the diagonal line up and down so it resembles a hill, a valley, and another hill. The input and output numbers don't have to match mine. To make our text look even more like Chrome, make a copy of the curves layer by pressing Ctrl or Command J, and then clip it. Next, we'll add a gradient. Ctrl-click or Command-click the thumbnail of your text to make a selection of its shape. Go to Select, Modify, and Contract. Contract it 3 pixels, and click OK or press Enter or Return. Go back to Select, Modify, and Feather. Feather it 2 pixels. Click the adjustment layer icon and click Gradient. The selection that you made from your text shape became a layer mask. This confines the gradient to just inside the layer mask. The gradient fill opens. Make the style linear, the angle 90 degrees, and check Align with Layer. Click the gradient bar to open the gradient editor. Click the black-white preset and click below the gradient bar in the middle to create another stop. To make sure it's in the middle, type in 50% in the location. Click the color box and pick white. Click the lower right stop, the color box, and pick black. Then, click OK on all three windows. Change the blend mode to multiply and reduce its opacity to 50%. Then, clip the adjustment layer. Make the copy active and change its blend mode to vivid light. Next, we'll add a subtle reflection on the automobile's surface. But first, we'll make a composite snapshot of our visible image by making the top layer active and creating a new layer above it. Then, press Ctrl-Shift-Alt-E on Windows or Command-Shift-Option-E on a Mac. Ctrl-click or Command-click the text to make a selection of its shape. Go to Select, Modify, and Expand. Expand it by 6 pixels and click OK or press Enter or Return. Press Ctrl or Command J, which cuts and copies your Chrome logo onto its own layer. We can trash the composite snapshot since we don't need it anymore. Ctrl-click or Command-click the cutout Chrome logo to make a selection of its shape. Alt-click or Option-click the layer mask icon to make an inverted layer mask of the selection next to our Chrome logo. Your layer mask should be white with a black silhouette in the center. Click the chain link icon to unlink the layer and the layer mask. Doing this allows us to resize and/or reposition the layer and the layer mask independently of the other. Make the cutout logo active and reduce its opacity to 15%. Drag it down and to the right approximately this much. Lastly, we'll add a lens flare on our logo. Make another composite snapshot of your visible image and go to Filter, Render, and Lens Flare. Make its brightness 75% and the lens type 50 to 300 mm zoom. Drag the flare to a bright area of your logo and click OK. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.